So guys, this is the Facebook Retargeter back office, and what you're going to simply do when you're in here, now Thomas and I made this super, super simple. And the reason is because, well, obvious reason, it's always best to keep things simple, right? The easier and the simpler things are, the easier it is to understand and, you know, implement. So there's three simple steps that you're going to do. The first thing you're going to do is something called the retargeting audience, right? You're going to name your audience. So for example, I'm going to name this audience, just as an example, Chris and Susan, right? Just because we're on their hangout right now. So that's the name of the audience, right? Of course, you would have your own audience name, whatever you're promoting, whatever name you want to choose. Now, the next step is to get a retargeting pixel. Now, really quick, what a pixel is, folks, in simplest terms, it's a little it's a little bit of information that is installed on your website so that when people do visit your site, that information picks up that visitor and adds them to your Facebook list. That's all it is. It's just a little bit of information placed on your website. Now, you know, in technical terms, it's HTML. And a lot of you folks may or may not be familiar with that. But HTML is the coding of your site. Now, a lot of you may be saying, well, Robert, I don't know HTML. I don't know coding. I want to stay away from that. Me too, trust me. So that's why Thomas and I made this so simple. We literally made it so that you don't have to do anything with your HTML code. You don't have to hire a programmer or any of that stuff. You're going to see me do this and how simple this is. So the second step is getting that pixel, right? So we're going to click here, which is Get Facebook Pixel Here. So when we click that, it's going to bring us into our back office of Facebook advertising. What I'm going to do next, because we made it so that it brings you directly into your audience tab, and just in case if you guys are not brought here when you click that, that only means you don't have a Facebook advertising account set up yet. And if that happens, all you do is go to fb.com/ads, which spells ads. That's all you do. You set up your account, and then the next time you click into this, it will load into this. Now, once you do that, folks, you're going to click on Create Audience, right? Now, you may or may not be familiar with this process, but there are a couple of ways to upload a custom audience. There's a data file. There's a MailChimp, which is an email autoresponder. There's a custom audience from your mobile app, and then there's a custom audience from your website. So obviously, we're going to build a custom audience from our website. So we're going to click the last one on the bottom. Then it tells us, it asks us to enter some very simple information. Audience name, I would do the same name. It doesn't matter. But I'm just doing this for example purposes. I'm going to zoom in on this page a little bit just because it might be a little small. so I did Chris and Susan just for an example name. You can name it whatever you like. Description, this is just so that when you look at your audiences, you can know what they are. I'm just going to put Google Hangout with rock stars. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to click View Custom Audience Pixel. So when I click that, folks, it gives you everything you need, all of the code, all the HTML. You don't have to do any of this. So all you do is you click it once, and then you're going to copy it. On a Mac, you can do Command-C. On a PC, you could do Control-C, or you can simply right-click on this and hit Copy. Then what you're going to do is go back to your Facebook Retargeter back office. You're going to, you know, click right in here, and you're going to hit Command-V, or if you're on a PC, Control-V. Or, you, again, you can right-click and hit paste. That's all you have to do with that, folks. Now, how simple was that? Super, 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 super simple. Now, because we don't want any domains to be used so much and for Facebook to, you know, see an excessive use of a domain name, what we do for our users is we give them a choice of domains to use. Now, you know, we have a good amount of domains here. And we kept them all generic names. Click the image today, click the photo now, click the photo today, get started, visit the photo now. We made it all so that they're call to actions to the actual ad you do. So long story short, you can select any one of these, and you also have the option with Facebook Retargeter to use your own domain. So we recently installed a Facebook Retargeter WordPress plugin that you would simply download and you would install to your own domain. So Chris and Susan, if they wanted their ads to display as chrisandsusan.com underneath their Facebook ad, they would download the plugin, and they would actually install that plugin, which is very simple, and then they would have the ability to use their own domain. Now, I'm going to just use clicktheimagetoday.com for an example right now. And now the last step, folks, is putting in your landing page. So this is the page that you want people to be added to your list when they visit. So for example, if we were doing the site chrisandsusanbeasley.com, this would be the actual site that you want to send. This is the site that you want people that visit your site to be added to your list. Now, all you're going to do, folks, is hit generate URL. It's literally that simple, folks. We did that in literally less than a minute, and maybe a little longer, only because I'm explaining the process. What you're going to do next is simply just copy this. So we put a little button here. You could just click that. It copies it to your clipboard. And now this is the URL that you're going to promote out there. Now, there are free methods for you to promote on Facebook. And I've had a lot of success on Facebook. There are, you know, certain ways, like you can promote your link in Facebook groups. You could promote your link, you know, creating an event for Facebook. You can actually, send your... Now, for example, I'm going to send Chris and Susan a message here on Facebook. We're going to do this live with you folks, if that's okay. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Chris and Susan's page, and I'm going to send them a message. And I'm going to send them a message with that link that I copied to the clipboard, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to send them that link in a message. And Chris and Susan, if you can just click that link, let the page open up. I'm going to do it here as well. And if I'm not mistaken and I typed everything correctly, it should go to chrisandsusanbeasley.com if I spelled everything correctly. And there it is. Now, this is the site that you want everyone to go to. So now, with this link that I created, if Chris and Susan use this link, of course they could, create their own. When someone visits this, they are now added to that Facebook audience list that I created a few minutes ago. Chris and Susan, can you just let me know? Did you guys happen to get that message and were able to click it?
I'm just gonna click on it now.
Okay, cool. Just let me know. And what I want to share with you folks that are watching is what we've created in the back office is a little bit of a dashboard where all the links that you create will be here. So you go to your Facebook retargeter links, and every single link that you create with Facebook retargeter will have the name of it, will have the unique clicks and the total clicks. So right now you see 3 clicks. I think they may have clicked on it twice, or I clicked on it, but you see the clicks are there. Now if I go to the site again, right, if I type in the site again and it's loading, it'll actually, put again another click there. So we wanted to keep the tracking for everyone very easy, because what happens is Facebook is not always the most reliable place to see how many clicks you've gotten or how big is your audience. They take a little while to update that. So long story short, you got your landing page URL here, which you can actually, the main thing you're going to do here is, if you ever want to go back to get your links or you want to edit something, you would just click the edit. You can delete your links if you ever wanted to delete it, no more of use. You can copy them, or you can launch the site here, whichever link, just to see where they go really quick. So we made a lot of different options here to make it very easy for the user to use. Now, really quick, what we're going to do, we're going to go back to the Facebook window, right, because we created that URL now. We have the information here. And all we're going to do is we're going to leave it on all website visitors. Now, for the amount of days that your pixel stays alive, right, there's a certain time that your pixel stays alive for. The max is 180 days. I always recommend putting the top amount, unless you have a promotion for like 7 days or 30 days, and you only want to keep that pixel alive for a certain amount of days. There aren't too many circumstances that you want to limit the amount of days that your pixel is alive. So I would just put 180 days just to keep that simple. So now what I'm going to do is hit create. Thank you for creating a custom audience. Your audience is ready. So now that I have this audience back here, anytime a visitor visits that link that I sent to Chris and Susan or that I created here in Facebook Retargeted Back Office, they are going to be added to this list right here. So this is a custom audience that I'm building based on visitors. Now, some of you might be saying, well, Robert, okay, I get it. Let me just do a quick overview. So I'm going to create a Facebook retargeter link with Facebook retargeter. I'm going to create an audience with Facebook and grab that pixel and put it into the Facebook retargeter. I got that. Now I have my link that Facebook retargeter created. Now what do I do with that link, Robert? Am I only going to put them in Facebook groups and Facebook posts and chat and all of those free methods? Sure, you can if you'd like, because that'll build your audience. But a faster way to do that is with paid advertisement. So what do I mean? Well, let's say we wanted to create an ad. I'm going to go to campaigns. This is one of my accounts. I'm going to go to campaigns, and I'm going to click on the top right corner as soon as it loads, create ad, right? And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on either clicks to website or a page post engagement. Now, I'm not going to go too deep into this. Maybe another hangout we can go into depth. And also in our back office for Facebook Retargeter, we go into depth with this. But for your, you know, for respect for your time, as well as Chris and Susan's, I'm going to actually just share with you that the most common ones that are selected by me and, you know, very, you know, the most, the top industry leaders that are utilizing Facebook most with the most results are usually these, clicks to website and page post engagement. So just for example purposes, I'm going to click on clicks to website. Let's say we just wanted to promote that straight to the site. I'm going to paste the link that Facebook Retargeter created right in there, and then I'm going to let it load. Now, of course, you're going to select a few images that you want to promote to that audience. So again, remember, folks, these are people that visited your site. So if we were doing this site, which we are, I would actually get a few pictures, maybe this one right here, you know, of how great Chris and Susan look right here. And I would actually screenshot that or take a picture and maybe put, you know, a little bit of text here that says, thank you for visiting our site. We look forward to seeing you again. Or click here to come back and visit. You want to put a message that, you know, that reads well, and also people will see that and say, wow, that is so cool. How they knew I was on their site and now I'm seeing it again. You know, of course you don't, you know, you want to be a little bit smart with your message and your image for your ads. And again, we go into training in depth in the back office with as far as that. So for example purposes, let's just say we selected a few images here and we wanted to, you know, create our headline. You know, I'm just going to put something, you know, thank you for visiting. Thank you for visiting. Again, this is not what you would put for your copy. I'm just putting an example. We appreciate it, you know, and click here. We appreciate it. Click here to revisit. Just an example. I'm not really thinking too well right now, but that's just an example. Of course, you would change it up. Now, the main thing I wanted to show you is for your custom audiences, now that you've created that custom audience, right, we all did that together, what you're going to do is when you click in here, you're going to see your custom audiences. Now, now you may have a lot of custom audiences in here that say data file or data file. Those are audiences that you may have uploaded from, you know, with your email list or audiences that have been scraped from user IDs. Now, I'm going to talk about that in just a moment because I want you to know the difference between what is allowed on Facebook and what is not to make sure you guys are 100% in the clear. So really quick, before we get into that, I'm going to actually go down to right here. See this list right here? I'm going to zoom in a little bit just so you guys can see it. This list right here is the one we just made, Chris and Susan, and it says website. Why? Because that's the one we created for visitors that go to a website. Now, we don't want to select that because, again, we are already promoting the link to the site. What we want to select are other audiences that we have in our custom audiences. So let's say, for example, you know, for example purposes, I wanted to send my AWeber, you know, or some of my leads for my email list over to Chris and Susan's, to that site. Every time somebody from this list visits that site, they're going to continue to see the ad on their Facebook. So for example, I'm just going to select that. I would clear out all the locations and everything else because we have a custom audience, and that's it. All you do is you create your ad, and you can start as low as a budget of $5. And there is some, you know, other training that we go over in the Facebook retargeting back office. Although that's as simple as it gets, folks. You place your order, and now what's happening is people that are in this custom audience that I had before are to see the ad that I created for this campaign. Now, some of you folks may be saying, well, Robert, I'm brand new to advertising. I don't even have one single custom audience. Well, that's okay, because what you're going to do is when you're here in the back office, right, this is going to be empty, right, and you're creating your ad. What you're going to do is you're going to go down to where it says interests. Now, these precise interests, folks, are very, very targeted that Facebook uses their algorithm and all the information they have to target those that have a certain interest. So with Chris and Susan, who are people that I would want to target that will be interested in what they have to offer? Well, the obvious ones, right, are internet marketing, right? So I would type that in. It would automatically search, and it would give you different examples too. So I would select internet marketing, and then I type it in again. Maybe I want to do one more interest. I would do internet marketing for newbies, right? And you can go on more and more, right, and add more to that. If you, you know, move your mouse over it, it shows you the amount of people, 34,032 people in that audience. And then this one is a big audience, 949,865 people. Now, before, you know, interests were not that targeted. And a lot of people would say, oh, stay away from those, just use custom audiences. And that was true. But now, things have changed, folks. The interests are working extremely well. Now, another thing that they added to the Facebook advertising back office is something called behaviors. So now what they're allowing you to do is target people that have certain purchase behaviors. So now you can target people that have actually purchased something on Facebook or through an ad before. I know a lot of you are saying, wow, are you kidding me, Robert? I cannot believe what I'm hearing. And I'm only assuming that because that's what I said when I learned about this. And I'm sure Chris and Susan, you know, they're probably beside themselves, and they may already know about this, but this is so powerful that now with behaviors, I could simply come in here and click on purchase behavior, and I could actually select the niche or the industry or the type of purchases that they've made. So would I select something like clothing for this ad? No. Why? Because Chris and Susan, as far as I know, are not promoting their clothing company, or if they even have one, right? It doesn't make sense. Food and drinks, no. Health and beauty, no. Home and garden. These are just all the different ones. Household products, kids products, pet products, purchase habits. I'd probably go there. So if I go to purchase habits, then it says offline buyers or online buyers. So do you think online buyers would be a really good match? Absolutely. So now, folks, and you can add more to that, now we are targeting internet marketing and internet marketing for newbies that are people who actually purchased and pulled out their credit card to make a purchase of a product or service. Are you guys freaking excited or what? So anyway, now all of these people that you're targeting now with your ad, and they're showing that ad all over the place. You know, maybe this ad obviously won't be, you know, where, oh, thank you for visiting. Maybe this ad, you'll create an image that says, hey, come check out our new product, or come check out, you know, our blog, right? Because that was Chris and Susan's blog over here. So, of course, the message will be different depending on if you're, you know, who you're sending your ad to and who is seeing your ad. Obviously, these people have never been to your site yet, so you want to put something that attracts them to come visit. Why? Because now, since you're using the retargeting link, every time they click on it, guess what's happening? They are being added to your Facebook custom audience that you've created with that pixel installed in it. Isn't that freaking amazing? Now, once you start, because what's going to happen, folks, is you're going to start building a big list, right? There's going to start being a lot of people in that custom audience for Chris and Susan, the one we made. So then what do then? Well, you want to retarget that audience. So that's when you would come in here. And again, folks, you're not doing all of this at the same time. I'm just staying on this page to give you the different examples and different scenarios. So what you would do is when you have that audience, let's say a week or 2 weeks or a month down the line, and you want to start promoting and retargeting that audience, I would actually encourage you to do it as soon as possible. But first you have to build that list, right? Which we did with a few ads that I'm showing you examples of how to do. But once you have that list and it's starting to have 1,000, 2,000, 3,000 people on that list, what you're going to do then is when you create your ad, you're going to click on Chris and Susan, right? You're going to click on the audience you created for that, and then you're going to start promoting images, obviously, and ads that say, hey, thanks for visiting. Thanks for come back to our site. I'm going to pause for a moment, and I want to hear from Chris and Susan. I want to see, I don't want to go too fast. Sometimes I get so excited. I share a lot. I want to make sure that everybody, and Chris and Susan, if you have any questions as well that you feel obviously will help everyone else, let me pass it to you guys first, and then we'll continue.
Well, we had to jump back quickly in our seats because we were out there trying to create something while you were talking. No, joking apart. It's absolutely incredible. And I have to say, although I your sales video that explains what Facebook Retargeter is, and any of you guys watching that sales video and understanding it, you have been given a much deeper insight here. It's like the secret sauce before you even had access and bought it, because believe me, this is going to be one of the best ways of building your list, because we talk about, as online marketers and online business owners, and in fact as an offline business owner, you should be building a list of people who are interested in your products and services. And it hasn't been until fairly recently, and we're talking not more than a few years, that people have started to do this with serious intent. We've known it, and we've done it for the past 4 years. And like you, Robert, we've got a very, very large list of subscribers. And like you say, some people don't buy in the moment. They wait for some time, and it can be some years. And now we have a much better opportunity, and I hope you're all seeing this as you're thinking, I should be buying this. You should be buying it, because believe me, this is going to give you so many options.
Well, go ahead, Chris.
Yeah, just think about this one, and this is, you know, for those of you who understand how internet marketing works, and even if you're a total brand newbie, you will understand how internet marketing works because you've been through the process. Okay, so when you click on an ad or you click on a link, whether it's in Facebook or whether it's on or another website, okay, a lot of the time you get taken to a lead capture page. So Robert mentioned lead capture pages earlier, and he said, in exchange for a gift of some sort, it might be a training video, it might be an ebook or whatever, you're asked for your details so that can be delivered to you. Now, if you did some paid marketing and you sent, let's say 500, or let's say 1,000 people, because I can work the numbers, let's say you got somebody to send 1,000 clicks to your website, your lead capture page. And let's say that lead capture page converts at 30%. So 300 people who visit that page will leave their name and email address. What happens to the other 700?
Boom!
You've lost them!
Exactly. I love it. I love it. You guys excite me while I hear you guys talk about it, because there's so much power in it. That the possibilities are endless. And really quick, you know, a lot of you may be sitting on the edge of your seat right now as you're listening to the sounds of our voice, and you're saying, you know, I already clicked the button. You know, I already bought it, right? Some of you guys are saying, well, what's the price? Well, I kind of want to put it out there and say, what do you think a price would be worth it for something like this? For something that, like Chris just mentioned, where you buy a solo ad or, you know, some type of advertisement, email blast, and you're paying for that solo ad, and only 30% of the people, if that, are opting in, and the other 70% of those people vanish and you never see them again. What is that worth it to you? What is that worth it to your business to be able to follow up with not only the people who opted in, but the other 70% of people that have not? Right? I mean, would that double your business? Would it triple? Would it quadruple?
Yeah, we just want to thank you, I think, Robert, because, you know, it's great to be able to promote products that you know are going to help people. But I think it's something else altogether for the creator of that product to actually come live on a webinar, sharing their screen and explaining through visual aids, if you like, how it works. And they're just being able to give people an insight into the inside of to exactly what they're buying before they actually buy it. And I just think that's so powerful that it enables people to actually see what's going on so they can make an honest and a really informed decision.
And, you know, I want to add to that as well, because I think this is the era of a new way of doing business that hasn't existed before. I know when we first came online 4 years ago, we called them the internet magicians. They were people who hid behind pretty pictures and, you know, you just bought something and you got it and then you went to try and use it and found there was no support, no nothing behind it. In fact, it was just a smoke screen. And, you know, we've all been there. We've been caught up in that kind of stuff. I'm sure Robert has as much as we have. And I think the future of tools and resources to help us market our businesses better are going to become like this. And I'm really proud to be associated. We're both very proud to be associated with you, Robert, and with Thomas and your other business partners in the creation of your other products, because we know the thought that goes into them.